why the young people should represent, see this the carbon cycling as held in the age of global restoration. And her hopes for this, this meeting today. Thank you, Tara.
Yes, my name's Tara. I'm a sixth form student currently. And what I've got to say, I'm going to say. Not our problem, not our responsibility. Unfortunately, this is the attitude we're getting from quite a lot of adults nowadays. And sure, when it comes down to it, this is my generation's problem. We're the ones facing an uncertain future, facing food shortages, and an ever-growing population in ever-growing poverty. We're facing a world in which one step forward, 10 steps back becomes the new norm, where fossil fuels are gone and renewable energy is only available to a few. While only estimates, some scientists have given us fewer than 10 years before our source of oil runs dry, and little more than 20 for coal. Some have been more generous, getting around 100 years more of fuel consumption. Unfortunately, it's figures like these that fuel the fires, so to speak, of denial and the passing off of responsibility by those with the most power to make a difference. Those who've helped most to contribute to the consume and dump society that we've developed are those least willing to do something about it. For all the claims that plans are made to protect future generations in areas such as finance, employment and education, none of these will matter if you don't have a suitable planet on which to live sustainable lifestyles. Young people are the future, and we need an innovative action plan for tackling the problems of global warming, fuel and food shortages before it's too late. Carbon cycling offers every step needed to restore this world to one that can supply plentiful vegetation, alternative and renewable options for everyone, and a safe and secure future for our families and our planet. I'll be honest, at face value it can look too good to be true, and sometimes I wonder whether it is. But we're risk-taking people. Sometimes we need to do something different, something we may not understand completely or may not be able to guarantee the outcome of. Where would the world be without Martin Luther King, Bill Gates, Richard Branson, Nelson Mandela? I put a question out to students at my school. What do you really think about the current environmental state? Well, I got back some incredibly intuitive answers that really do prove how much of a standing young people have in the debate about our future world. Despite what people's opinions may be on teenagers and young adults, we have 15-year-olds providing actual solutions to current problems, often showing more insight and understanding of how things really are than some might care to admit. One person involved in discussions replied with a quote, "What's the use of a fine house if you haven't got a tolerable planet to put it on?" That's a quote by Henry David Thoreau, arguably one of the greatest philosophers today, and one that really does shape this whole discussion to its core. Young people today, especially those in higher and further education, are being streamlined into the set lifestyle, practically poured into the same mould that everybody else is. Get a degree, get a well-paid job, start a family, work for the next 50 years and then retire. But what good is any of the preparation we're being given if we don't actually have a place to live out those lives? Young people, more than senior politicians with degrees or scientists involved in developing all kinds of groundbreaking technology, are most qualified to contribute to decisions about our future world. We're in touch with the reality and the gravity of the situation, and it's our world that's being destroyed. In fact, the United Nations said youth comprise nearly 30% of the world's population. The involvement of today's youth in environment and development decision-making and in the implementation of programmes is critical to long-term success. As many of you are aware, this is the third time that Greg, FREdome Trust and everyone else involved in the carbon cycling campaign has been in discussions in this very place. We can all accept that sometimes things move slowly, but I believe what young people want, need even, out of these discussions here this evening, is reassurance that positive steps are being made towards restoring our planet to its former glory, and our futures along with it. By the time most of us are old enough to even get our foot in the door to make a significant difference, it could all be too late. So please, if nothing else comes of this, and I know it's the hopes of everybody here that more does, I wish that you go away with the knowledge that young people are ready, willing and able to be put on the front line in discussions and decision making about the environment and the world that we will have to live in, and what we have coined the age of global restoration.
Thank you.